I know what you're asking yourself, and the answer is yes. I have a nickname for my penis. It's called the Octagon. But I also nickname my testes. My left one is James Westfall, and my right one is Dr. Kenneth Noisewater. If you ladies play your cards right, you just might get to meet the whole gang.
Hello, everyone. Tonight I'm reading from softnet.com. Do narcissists know they are narcissists? I found another one of these. I love these. Barry Scott Kaufman. And the reason I love these is because even Sam Vaknin contradicts himself. Okay? And much of the research out there on narcissism does. That, you know, on one hand, they say, well, they're stuck at a developmental age, which I believe is true, but I don't believe it's because of trauma and abuse. I think trauma and abuse can make it worse if you have narcissism. And narcissism, I put on the spectrum similar to autism. So it's just a lack of development in morality. So anyway, some people say that, you know, they're stuck at a developmental age, they lack self-awareness, and they lack empathy, okay? And the research shows that there's obvious defects in the frontal lobe part of the brain where the mirror neurons are, and that's how you develop empathy later on in life when your brain grows and develops. Well, that part of their brain does not grow and develop. I've actually read research papers where it shows that the brain actually in that area shrinks from non-use. So anyway, to my point is that in one breath they say narcissists lack self-awareness, so they're not aware of their behaviors, and because they lack empathy, they're not willing to change their behaviors. They don't care. They have a sense of entitlement, and they think they're special. But then on the other hand, other researchers show that, and some of the same ones say the same things back and forth, that narcissists are very well, as well as psychopaths, that they're different at a very young age, usually typically around adolescence. Okay, which again suggests some type of developmental disorder. And they're very aware that they're different and that they have an advantage. And that advantage is no empathy. So they learn how to fake empathy, and they learn that they can sleep like babies at night and screw people over all over the place. And because of that lack of empathy, that makes them special beings because they get very good at manipulating, lying, conning. They don't have to follow the rules. They realize this, that other empathetic people believe them. They believe their lies if they put on the right persona. So some of the same research, they go back and forth and contradict themselves a lot of the times and say, yes, they're aware that they're different. They're aware that they have an advantage. So which one is it, guys? That's always been my question. Okay. So how self-aware are narcissists? Think of your friendly neighborhood narcissist, status-seeking, grandiose, loudmouth, brash, and flamboyant. Have you ever noticed how he or she brags all the time, not only about his astronomical IQ and bulging pectoral muscles, but also about the fact that he is a narcissist? It's as if he's proud of it. Now, obviously, they're not talking necessarily about covert narcissists, okay? I think the covert narcissists are a lot smarter, and I think they do realize they have a disadvantage in one way or another, and that would be good looks or a special talent. Maybe they're not a genius piano player or whatever, or artist, you know, so they go undercover and manipulate. Oh, wait, back to the article. Lots of psychologists have theorized that a lack of self-awareness is a hallmark trait of narcissists. My personal experience with narcissists does not seem to support this. It seems to me as though they are not only aware of who they are, but they embrace it. Luckily, I do not have to rely on personal anecdotes. To get to the bottom of this age-old mystery, Erica Carlson and her colleagues at Washington State University in St. Louis conducted three very well done studies to see whether narcissists have insight into their personality and their reputation. The results will soon be published in the prestigious Journal of Personality and Social Psychology. The researchers administered a number of different measures of narcissism to college students and looked at how high scorers are seen by others, how they see themselves, and how they believe they are seen by others. They look across social contexts and interviewed new acquaintances as well as friends and family. Their results across the three studies are strikingly consistent. Unsurprisingly, they found that narcissists think they are hot stuff. Those scoring high in narcissism tend to rate themselves as more intelligent, physically attractive, likable, and funny than others. Interestingly, they also rated themselves as having higher levels of negative aspects of narcissism, such as being power-oriented, impulsive, arrogant, and prone to exaggerate their abilities. Therefore, narcissists are aware they are narcissists. There was also a strong positive correlation between narcissism and having a reputation for narcissism. Narcissists were definitely perceived as narcissists. While other people didn't think the narcissists were nearly as hot as the narcissists thought they were, the narcissists were well aware of their reputation. When asked how others perceived them on the positive traits, their results were closer to how they were actually perceived than their own self-perceptions of the very same traits. These results suggest that narcissists do indeed have self-awareness of themselves and know their reputation. This begs the question, how can narcissists maintain their inflated self-image even though they know full well how they are perceived by others? The researchers suggest a few intriguing possibilities. And again, now I'm going to interject here. They're experts at perception management. Keep that in mind. That's all they do is perception management. Only their closest people to them that actually live with them know what monsters they are, really. Anyone else that doesn't really live with them is going to get screwed over one way or another, not even see it coming, not even put it together for years, even if they even do put it together. I know that's how my narcissist operates. But if they're experts at perception management, then they're very well aware of how others perceive them, especially when they're switching masks to suit each and every different person. Okay, back to the article. The researchers suggest a few intriguing possibilities. Perhaps narcissists assume that others are just failing to recognize how bitchin' they really are. They may think that people are just too dim to recognize their brilliance. Another possibility is that narcissists may think critics are just jealous of them. Narcissists may take negative feedback and think to themselves, those haters are just jealous. This may explain why narcissists behave in arrogant ways instead of compensating for some deep-seated insecurity. Bragging may be their way of demanding the recognition they truly believe they deserve. Narcissists score up the kazoo in entitlement. As the researchers note, this idea is consistent with self-verification theory. Quote, narcissists believe that they are exceptional people and may behave in arrogant ways because they are attempting to bridge the gap between their self-perceptions and their meta-perceptions, unquote. The researchers also suggest it's possible that narcissists maintain their self-image by misconstruing the meaning of narcissism. I love that because of course they would. They know how to take a word and give it 100 different meanings to suit their purposes and leave you sitting there confused and scratching your head because it always makes just enough sense. So when told they are arrogant, instead of thinking they are someone who is confident without merit, they may take it as a compliment. Thinking to themselves, well, duh, I'm arrogant, if by what you mean, deservedly confident. As the researchers note, narcissists seem to choose honest arrogance when describing themselves and their reputation. The result of this study, as well as prior studies, suggests that narcissists do care more about being perceived as superior or agentic traits, industrious, assertiveness, dominance, compared to communal traits, agreeableness, and honesty. Narcissists don't seem to care whether they are perceived as good people. They rather be admired than liked. That's true. So perhaps the narcissist in their study construed supposedly negative aspects of narcissism, e.g. arrogance, as desirable. Of course, it's also possible that narcissists are fully aware of the meaning of narcissism and the negative impact they have on others, but just don't care as long as it doesn't get in the way of their goals. The researchers also found that new acquaintances viewed narcissists more positively than well-acquainted others. Those who just met the narcissist did tend to have a favorable impression of the narcissist, whereas those who knew the narcissist much longer tended to have a much more negative impression of the narcissist. Wow, I can speak to that one. Again, the narcissists in their sample were fully aware of this. The results suggest that narcissists understand that they make positive first impressions that deteriorate over time. These results are consistent with prior research that has shown that narcissists have trouble forming long-term relationships. Narcissists tend to think they are too good for most people and are always seeking better relationship alternatives. The results are also consistent with research showing that narcissists are masters at first impressions. As researchers have suggested, the narcissist's success at creating initial attraction may make short-term contexts more rewarding for them than longer-term contexts. It's impossible that narcissists discontinue relationships early on because they cannot bridge the gap between their positive self-perceptions and relatively negative meta-perceptions. Practical implications. It is well known that narcissists rarely change, mostly because they don't want to change. They love their lifestyle. Researchers trying to reform narcissists have noticed that a major impediment is their lack of self-awareness. They have speculated that if narcissists received true feedback, they would change. Good luck with that one. Oh, no wonder. Don't even bother. If you're a psychologist out there who thinks they're going to save a narcissist, don't bother. They'll have you in the loony bin faster than you can say boo. The Carlson and colleagues study suggests that it is not the case. Narcissists are fully aware that they are narcissistic and have a narcissistic reputation. Instead, the researchers suggest that a better intervention would be to emphasize the interpersonal and intrapsychic costs of being seen as narcissistic by others. Narcissists are unlikely to change unless they think changing will benefit the things they desire, such as status and power. Are you a narcissist? Many of you are probably reading this and wondering whether you are a narcissist. An implication of the results I just reviewed is that if you are a narcissist, you probably already know it. And it's safe to say if you get really scared when you think, oh my God, am I a narcissist? That would be horrible. If you ask that question and you're really scared that you might be, you're not a narcissist. Not even close if you're worried about it. In reality, all of us are at least a little bit narcissistic, and I'll just add in here, of course we have to be. Narcissism is essential to our ego functioning. In the studies just reviewed, the researchers administered a narcissistic questionnaire to college students. Even though they found that the students scored all across the spectrum, it's not as if there was anyone who was completely non-narcissistic, and just for the reasons I mentioned above. All of us throughout the day ebb and flow in and out of narcissistic mindset. Still, you might be worrying that you are consistently extremely narcissistic. There are plenty of rubbish tests all over the internet to claim to be a good measure of narcissism. Forget them. The best test I've found by far is this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention? I've just been handed an urgent and horrifying news story. And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen. Cannon!